Hello students, welcome to my online session. So today we would be learning about Bengali cuisine. I'm Chef Aditya Saxena from Chitkara School of Hospitality. So today we would be learning about, you know, the geographical location, the historical background, what are the different ingredients, what are the different kinds of fishes that the Bengali people eat. What are the equipments that they use? What are the, their staple diet? What are the different festivals of Bengal? What is their different type of, you know, different style of cooking? So we would be covering all these things in today's session. It would be an interesting session for us to generally know about Bengali cuisine. So let's begin with Bengali cuisine. Bengali cuisine, the introduction part. The Bengali cuisine, is of food preparation. Originating in Bengal, a region in the eastern southeastern Asia, or we can say the eastern India, now which is now divided between the Indian state of West Bengal, Tripura, and Barak Valley of Assam, and the country of Bangladesh. So this whole area was known as Bengal priorly, but later was divided by the Britishers. Now with an emphasis on fish and lentils served with rice as a staple diet, Bengali cuisine, is known for its subtle yet sometimes fiery flavors. The flavors of Bengali food are subtle. Now the food is generally, the food of people. So the Bengali food is never a spicy one, but it has a lot of flavors. Now fish is a staple diet, rice is a staple diet, as there's a lot of rain, the plains are quite fertile, there is a lot of water, so rice is generally eaten a lot. Bengalis have a sweet tooth, they do eat a lot of sweets. Mustard is integral part of their food. It is known as Kashundi in Bengal. Is a variety of mustard. Bhajas are different vegetables that is being eaten. Chhols are the curries that is are made and prepared. And panchphoran is a spice mixture. It contains five different spices, whole spices. Or inhi ka tadka lagta hai khana preparation ke type. So let's begin with our Bengal cuisine. Now, if we talk about the geographical location. Talk about the West Bengal, on the eastern side it borders with Bangladesh, on the western side it has border with Bihar and Jharkhand, and on the southern side it touches Orissa. North we have got Himalayas, in south of Bengal we have got Sundarbans, and two great rivers of India they merge here, which is Ganga and Brahmaputra. The Bengal region lies is in the low line Ganga and Brahmaputra Delta or the Ganges Delta. Yahan par aakar ke milte hain and they fall into the sea. The Ganga Delta arises from the confluence of the rivers Ganga, Brahmaputra and Meghna River and their respective tributaries. So by knowing this, we know Bengal has lot of waterways there. The Bengal region today comprises of parts of West Bengal and Bangladesh. The West Bengal is on the eastern bottleneck of India, stretching from the Himalayas in the north to the Bay of Bengal in the south. In Bengal, the major practice of cultivation is of paddy. Rice bahut zyada grow hota hai yahan par. The average rainfall over the region, the type of soil, and the cultural practice prefer to grow paddy because lot of the land is fertile, lot of water is there, the rainfall bahut hoti hai, jis wajah se yahan pe rice ki jo cultivation hai wo bahut zyada hoti hai. If we talk about the historical background, now Bengali food has inherited a large number of influence from foreign traders and of pan-Indians. Bengali cuisine is perhaps the only cuisine in the Indian region which still holds its authenticity for over 1000 of years. The region has been ruled by Mughal emperors and was also the capital of British India. Now the British India, when they started grabbing the land of India, their first capital was Calcutta. Then the capital was shifted to New Delhi when they grabbed the whole of India. Now though there has been a lot of influence in the cuisine from the Nawabs, Chinese, Britishers and Marwaris, the Bengali people still hold authenticity of their food. They still have that intact. The Nawabs or the Mughal rulers of the state for a very long time, and Mughal cuisine has a great impact on Bengali cuisine. You know, the muttons, the kormas, they have a lot of influence. But again, Bengalis has still influenced that kormas with their own traditional things. The key cultural influence of the Christian community was the ritual of tea. Tea is again an important snack in Bengal. They drink tea, they talk about literature, they talk about politics, they talk about the world economics, they talk about anything. Baking, which was pretty much unknown till the British came. So again, baking became an integral part of Bengali cuisine. The Chinese had a lot of influence. The chow mein or the Indian noodles that we eat, chow mein is originated in Bengal. Bengal has a lot of Chinese people living there, so their food eating habit has also been adapted by Bengalis. So Bengalis, they eat a lot of noodles, they eat a lot of dumplings, they eat a lot of paos, they eat a lot of chow mein. So chow mein. So these all things are adapted by the Bengalis. Now, if we talk about the ingredients, so there are a lot of ingredients that is being eaten by the Bengalis. Starting with start with the rice. Then we've got banana flowers. We have got the yams and radish. We've got jackfruit over here. We've got beans. We've got the leafy vegetables, and then we've got lemon and varieties of lemon. So there are a lot of vegetables that they eat. There are a lot of fishes that they eat. The most famous of them is Hilsa and Rohu. This is Hilsa and this is Rohu. Apart from that, they eat Betki and they eat Katla or Karp fish. The food of Bengal is, the food represents people of Bengal. The majority of people in Bengal were peasants. So what they used to do at that time was the men, they used to catch a fish, lekar aate the ghar mein, they used to clean it and the wife used to prepare it. Either they would have it with other peasants, and then what they used to do is do mitti ke bartan leke rakhte the, ek dande pe unko baandh lete the. एक मिट्टी के बर्तन में दे यूज्ड टू हैड वन राइस एंड ऑन सेकंड मिट्टी का बर्तन दे यूज्ड टू हैड माछी झोल और माछर झोल फिश कुक्ड इन लॉट ऑफ वाटर द माछर झोल्स आर जनरली यू नो सिंपल ग्रेवी ऑफ ऑनियन टमाटो व्हिच विद अ तड़का ऑफ पंचफोरन और नमक मिर्च हल्दी यही ज्यादा था इसके अंदर कुछ नहीं जाता था एंड पीसेस ऑफ फिश ऑल द थिंग्स वर कुक्ड इन मस्टर्ड ऑयल और एक रनी पतली ग्रेवी वाली कंसिस्टेंसी वाली फिश जो होती थी वो बन जाती थी विच इज यू नो सब्सटेंस और न्यूट्रिटिव होती थी एंड यू नो व्हेनेवर दे हैड टू ईट इट फिश और करी मिक्स करके बनाना लिख कर अपने खेतों में खाना खा लेते थे देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज द स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट्स दैट दे यूज इफ यू सी हियर करी This is, they call it hari, these are the different pans. This is jhanjari, which is a perforated spatula. Silnora is again a silbatta, which is quite typical to the Indian subcontinent. Kunki is a slicer that is being used to flip the fish pieces or taking out the rice. Sarshi is, you know, a sort of equipment, just say, बर्तन पकड़ सकते हैं, उठाकर दूसरी जगह रख सकते हैं। घुंडी इज जनरली मथनी जो हम बोलते हैं। बोंथ इज यू नो कटिंग इक्विपमेंट जिससे आप डिफरेंट तरीके की वेजिटेबल्स या फिशेस को, पीसेस को या नॉन वेज को काट सकते हैं। स्टेपल लाइट हम लोगों ने बात की थी, राइस है, वेजिटेबल्स है, लेंटिल्स थोड़ी कम है, डेयरी प्रोडक्ट्स यूज होते हैं, फिशेस काफ़ी यूज होते हैं एंड चटनीस काफ़ी ज़्यादा बनती है यहाँ पर। फूड की बात करें तो स्पेशल फेस्टिवल के टाइम पे बनता है लुच्ची, लुच्ची इज दिस, इन रेस्ट ऑफ इंडिया वी कॉल इट पूरी, इन बंगाल वी कॉल इट लुच्ची। नाउ देयर इज ओनली स्लाइट डिफरेंस, स्लाइट डिफरेंस इज जो बंगाल की लुच्ची है उसके अंदर रिफाइंड फ्लावर की क्वांटिटी थोड़ी ज़्यादा होती है, थोड़ा सा फ्लेक्सेस में सीज जाते हैं और उसके बाद उसको फ्राई किया जाता है। देन वी हैव राधा भलोबी, वी हैव भाजास, भाजास आर डिफरेंट वेराइटी ऑफ वेजिटेबल्स, ड्राइड वेजिटेबल्स। देन सोशी पाता इंग्लिश, इंग्लिश इज फिश, माछा पातुरी इज फिश कोट इन बनाना लीफ। देन वी हैव माछा मुठिया, पब्दा माछा चोल, दोई माछ इज अगेन फिश कोट इन विद बर्ड। काशा मांगशो इज टिपिकल बंगाली मटन डिश, इट जनरली टेक्स 5 to 6 hours to cook एंड इट इज मटन विच इज कुक्ड इन इट्स गुड जूसेस, सो नो एडिशन ऑफ फैट और वाटर इज बीइंग डन। प्लेट आलू पोस्तो, इन पोस्तो इज योर पॉपी सीड्स, इनका पेस्ट बनाया जाता है और उसके बाद पोटैटोस के साथ कुक किया जाता है। आलू पोस्तोस, देर आर डिफरेंट कुकिंग स्टाइल्स जो बंगाल में यूज किया जाता है। भापा अगेन कुकिंग इन स्टीम, देन भोरता मींस टू यू नो मैश इट, भोरता इज अगेन टू सौते हैं, चोरचू चिरी इज अगेन कुकिंग ऑन सम हाई हीट और चाइनीज स्टाइल के तरीके से। Then we have got dom, which is dum cooking, and chaal is again a sort of gravified cooking, and we have got tarkari, we have got kasha, we have got pora. So these are the different type of cooking styles that Bengalis they prefer to cook their food. So this is what we have done today. We have learned today. Please refer to the notes that has been given and stay tuned for some more videos. But meanwhile, please stay at home, please stay safe, wear a mask. Thank you very much.